celebrities who defy their age. They're over 50, they look amazing. What are the common denominators? What can you do? What can we learn? What do I learn in my practice from those patients who look amazing, who need less treatments? What is it they're doing? If we think about people like J-Lo, how about Elizabeth Hurley, Sandra Bullock? What about on the male side, Rob Lowe? A lot of people bring up Brad Pitt. He still looks great. Cindy Crawford. What do they have in common? What do they do? When I'm in my clinic and I'm treating patients, or I see them in follow-up at a year and I go, I don't think you need much of anything, I'm going to say, what is it that you're doing at home? What are your lifestyle factors? And that's what I'm sharing. I'm Dr. Rajani, and don't forget to subscribe and like these videos so I'll keep more coming to you. Number 5 is food. Now, with food, what do you do? What is the real takeaway message? It's eating real food. If you can taste it, it's likely real food. What do I mean by fake food? Processed sugars. They increase inflammation and they start something we call metabolic syndrome, which is a cascade of events of insulin resistance, carrying fat. That fat converts to estrogen and changes all kinds of hormones within the body, and it sets up an unhealthy cycle that leads to aging. Going to talk about hormones at the end as a bonus because it is important to know. I like organic foods. I like eating your vitamins. I have supplements on videos for those who just can't take food, they can't find the food, they don't think it's worthwhile, or they want a little extra boost because bone, vitamin K2, calcium, sun exposure for vitamin D, all those things are important. I have a complete video on nutrition. I'll put a link below. Like with all my 5 points, I'll put a more complete video in the more info section below. Number 4 is genes. Now this is difficult because you might say, well, Rajani, we can't change our genes, but you can be aware of the genes. If you think about things like Alzheimer's and the gene that expresses potential Alzheimer's increased risk of APOE4, if you have one of them, you're likely to get Alzheimer's. There's a likelihood, but if you have 2, you're more likely, but it doesn't mean you will. So these aren't specific genes, but they give you an idea of what you're predisposed to, and you can make lifestyle changes. Same thing with Parkinson's. There's a gene for that, and one of the owners of Google, Sergey Brin, has that gene, and he's taking a lot of money and putting it towards research. How does it apply to your skin? Well, genetically, those with oily skin are protected from aging. With pigments, so genes that produce pigment, it protects them from the sun's UV light and factors that kill collagen. The thickness of the skin, so thicker skin does not get the fine lines and wrinkles. And of course, males tend to have thicker skin, more testosterone, more oil. So if you have that type of genetic preponderance to that type of skin, darker, more oil, thicker, you might get what we call slide or sag, but you're not going to get the fine lines. So your treatment regimen is going to be much different. If you have thinner skin, lighter colored skin, red hair, bone plays a role. If you know you have early osteoporosis in the family, those are things that you can modify your lifestyle behaviors to make sure that those genes aren't going to create aging down the road. So you can take preventive steps. You can't change your genes, but you can make modifications. I have a complete video on things you can do, and one particular vitamin deficiency that may be wrinkling your skin. I put a link to that in the description below. Worth watching if you have that lighter colored skin and preponderance for bone loss. Number 3, regular treatments. I'm not talking about fillers that create contours, fillers that might last in your face for long periods of time or that can make you look unusual. What I'm talking about is valuing these 5 treatments. Number 1, chemical peels. Number 2, PDO smooth threads to help build collagen. Number three, microneedling. And if you want to do it at home, we have a home kit for growth factors and microneedling that you can watch my video on. But doing it in the clinic is worthwhile for many. They don't want to deal with it at home and they want different things infused, but there's value in it. Number four, platelet-rich fiber, and uses your own blood products, stimulates collagen, gives youthful skin. And number five, fractionated RF treatments, radio frequency, not laser energy, but combining those types of treatments on a regular basis. They don't make people look unnatural, but they help create youth. You'll find the stars have a regimen of treatments that they do to keep their skin beautiful and healthy. Now they also have the money to back that up. So it does cost money to maintain the skin for this, which was my number three. Number four is exercise. And it's very important. If you look at the stars, they're on an exercise routine. They often show it on their Instagrams. Look at their muscles, look at their body. Now they have the money for trainers, which a lot of people don't have. But if we don't have the money, we need to be self-motivated, and that's important. How do we know exercise works? Well, there's studies. There were studies done particularly at McMaster University in Canada where they looked at the skin of people who were sedentary, and then they looked at an exercise group, and they even took biopsies. The interesting part of that was they then found that skin was healthier in those who exercised, and they thought it was possibly interleukin-15, increased blood flow, hormones, many reasons. But here's the key. They took the sedentary group who had the biopsy showing not so good skin, they exercised them on the treadmill, and then they developed better skin after as soon as 6 weeks. So we know exercise, it's studied and proven, and it's a common denominator amongst the stars. Go to their Instagram accounts and watch. Number one tip, and I have a bonus one coming on hormones, so stay tuned, but it's sun exposure. It's something you can regulate, and if you watch them, they have wide-brimmed hats. Of course, they can afford the cabana, I get that, but they're not getting the sun exposure from it. They know to extend their career, sun kills skin. It kills the collagen production. It helps increase what we call MMPs, matrix metalloproteins. Also, the turnover of your natural hyaluronic acid, not the filler hyaluronic acid that we're injecting. The non-cross-linked hyaluronic acid in your body is made every day. It's broken up every day. And when that gets imbalanced, so you're making less hyaluronic acid, breaking down more, it deflates the face. We want the most collagen, hyaluronic acid, and we do not want the collagenases or the things that eat up our collagen. And not only does exercise and food modulate that, but sun is the number one killer. Sun's not all bad, but of course we need vitamin D, and that's cancer protective. There's many studies. I put a complete video below, also in the more info section, on sunscreen, ones you can use, safety, benzenes, all those things are covered in a more complete video. Now my bonus one. One thing you find when patients come into my clinic and they're doing well, of course, a lot of times they're doing all the aforementioned five things, but they're also on hormones, hormone replacement, bioidentical hormones. And if they're not on them because they can't take them because of risks of taking them, so when you think of estrogens, you think of things like clots, like a family history or personal history of estrogen-sensitive breast cancer, if they have the BRCA gene that exposes them to increased risk. They can't take hormones, however, they're aware of them. And below, I'll put in the more info section a video on how to increase testosterone naturally. And this is females we're talking about, but men also replace things like growth hormone, testosterone, but there are risks that come with that. So the more natural you can increase it, the better. But I'd be remiss not to say that so many of my workout, my healthy people, the people that look great, their dermis is thick, they're not getting fine lines, they have good bone structure, they're also attuned to their hormones. And you know, once a year, as I tell you all the time, I go down to the A4M, the anti-aging conference. I spend 4 days. There's steam coming out of my brain. There's so much information there because hormone replacement in the female, The male's somewhat easy in this respect, and the female is very complex and individual. You need to find the exact right person to guide you. It's not that simple. But the main ones we're talking about, estrogen, progesterone, testosterone. Those are five with a bonus tips that I find keep people young. They need less treatments. I put a complete playlist up here, things you can do at home. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.